Hi, everybody, and welcome to Ram Vision, another edition of Radio All Access. Brian Roth with you, flying solo without my partner, Mark Driscoll. Of course, Mark's going to rejoin me coming up on Saturday night when we say farewell to Hughes Stadium and the Rams get the New Mexico Lobos in town. We'll talk about the Lobos here in just a minute, but looking back to the Air Force game on Saturday night, tough loss for Colorado State, losing 49-46, and an old-fashioned whack shootout is what we were calling it. Fashions back to those mid-90s type games that the Rams and the Falcons used to have, but Colorado State just too many mistakes in the contest, weren't able to come out with the victory. But end of the contest, CSU with the football back down by 3. I don't think there was any doubt in our mind in the radio booth at Falcon Stadium, and probably a lot of minds of Ram fans, that Colorado State was going down the field to win that game. But alas, Michael Gallup bumbled the football and Air Force recovered. Of course, Gallup, we had him on our post-game show, felt terrible, said he was trying to make a play, and really that's all he was trying to do, is make a play. You can't fault him. He was the best player on the field for either team that night. 13 catches, 213 yards, and a touchdown. He continues to be the Rams' best player here. He has just, well, really gone into beast mode for Colorado State. The defense had a little trouble stopping that Air Force Falcon attack. Again, it's a young defense. First time they had faced an attack like that, and really just didn't have an answer. Forced a couple of turnovers, but other than that, that defense going to hope to bounce back against New Mexico coming up on Saturday night. Of course, it's the final game at Hughes. It'll be the final home game for a bunch of seniors on that team, and one of those is the All-American punter, Hayden Hunt. All right, Hayden, thanks for joining us. Give me your thoughts. The season so far, after the year that you had last year, you're backing it up with yet another great year.
You know, I just got to put it out there for the punt coverage unit. Great coaching by Coach Brian on the scheming, and, you know, I put a lot of hard work into it and just doing my thing every week, and so I'm not putting any more extra effort than I need, just doing myself.
Talk to me a little bit about the on the shorter kicks, when you're trying to pin the opponent deep in their territory, you have some kind of spin, you're trying to hit the ball a certain way. I saw you talking about that, I think, last year, but if you could take us through how you're trying to hit that.
Yeah, so traditionally on punting, I keep the ball flat, as you know. Nice. On the inside the 20, I put it at a, you know, facing down. I want to hit it like a field goal kick, get the backward spin. So there's only two options, that the bounce backwards or directly forward to one of our guys. And the higher you get, the slower rotation with a vet like me, you get the lucky bounces. You know how to get it to stop and go to a 90-degree angle towards the sideline. I did that on purpose, right?
Right, yeah. Which game was that?
That was UNLV.
That's right, the UNLV game, and it went right out the 1 yard line. But when you do that, you're literally trying to hit the point of the football almost, or just a little behind it?
Just a little behind it, like a field goal. So I'm just trying to hit a little behind it to get the back rotation, hit it hard as I can. 100% swing, just crushing it. It's a good time.
You were a Ray Guy finalist last season, one of three. Yeah. You're a semifinalist here this year. I mean, how much does that mean to you?
You know, it means a lot. You know, it's always nice to, you know, people to recognize what you do and all the hard work you put in the summer and the winter. And it means a lot, but, you know, when it comes down to it, I like that it's helping the team. It's putting specialists on a platform and, you know, just give me the opportunity to be an impact on this team rather than just be a specialist who doesn't do much.
Right. I heard you talking about high school here. You didn't kick much at all in high school. You were at Long Beach Poly, right? And that's one of the premier football programs in the nation, isn't it?
Yes, sir. High school school of the century by ESPN. So I got a lot of pride in Long Beach Poly, but all we did was kick PATs and kickoffs.
Right.
I wasn't the punter, and I think I had 13 field goal attempts. So it didn't do much, all touchdowns and winning.
Right.
So it's a big difference when you come to the college level, when there's a lot more competition.
There's nothing wrong with touchdowns and winning, I can tell you that. So how'd you end up at Colorado State?
Coach Skipper was actually recruiting me at Fresno, and Fresno and Colorado State were my biggest options, and he got the job with the McWine staff, and really liked the guy, a lot of character, brought me here and said the best opportunity, and you know, I came here as a kicker, lost to Jared Roberts, but it all worked out, and you know, I was looking at Fresno, and no bad mouth to Fresno, but the community at Fort Collins is so much better, the education's better, it's a rivalry, so I can talk bad. I just enjoy the city of Fort Collins and the college itself way better than the coaching staff. So.
Absolutely. Do you think about the NFL at this point? I know you're a little ways away. Does that cross your mind?
you know, it's hard not to. It's two games left, and, you know, when one put a third one out there for a bowl game,
yep.
it's hard not to think about it. But, you know, I'm really focusing on these last two games. Right. You know, last game, Hughes, it's a senior. I'm not trying to get too emotional, but I really want to appreciate the moment. So I think I'm really going to focus on that in the next few weeks.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that. What are going to be the emotions going into that game?
You know, it's going to be bittersweet. You know, I put a lot of hard work and love and blood, sweat, and tears into this team, and it's been such a big impact on my life and the kind of man I've been, grew up to be, and it's going to mean a lot. And I got to bring that all in and, you know, just put it all into punting and help our team win.
Absolutely. Listen, I know Ram fans don't like to see you come on the field. Yeah. It means we're giving the football back, but I got to tell you, in my years of watching football, I really get an enjoyment watching you kick. And when you boom one, you can boom one. And then, of course, when you bring out the old sand wedge and put the backspin on it, it's fun to watch. So we appreciate what you've done.
Well, I appreciate everything the fans, you know, giving me the opportunity and the love they've given me. You know, I'm the best probably in the country giving the ball away. So let's keep that up and win a game against New Mexico.
Yeah, and hopefully, no offense, you don't see the field
That'd be great.
In your last game at Hughes just like the Air Force game.
That would be a great experience, right? Go out, kick New Mexico's butt, and not play. But if I have to, I'm going to do what we can for the team. But as long as we get that W, that's all that matters.
All right, Hayden, best of luck.
I appreciate it. Have a nice night.
All right, that's senior punter Hayden Hunt. And, well, not only one of the best punters in the nation, certainly one of the best interviewers in the nation. Always a great guy to talk to. He has a legitimate shot to kick in the NFL coming up next year, but it'll be his final game at Hughes Stadium along with a bunch of other seniors coming up on Saturday night. So the New Mexico Lobos are in town. They sit at 7-3 in the season. Lobos at 5-1 in the conference along with Wyoming. New Mexico's got to be the other big surprise in the Mountain West Conference here this year. Bob Davis doing a nice job. Of course, they won 7 games last year, 7 games here this year. Important game on many different levels. Of course, we're saying farewell to Hughes Stadium. Final game out there at the base of Horsetooth Reservoir. Colorado State only has the 5 wins so far in the season. Still need one more to get bowl eligible, and they hope to do that coming up on Saturday night. Should be a fun one. We'll go on air at 6 p.m. on the Colorado State Sports Network. Kickoff set for 8:21. For Hayden Hunt, I'm Brian Roth saying so long. Thanks for joining us here on Ram Vision.